This is DuttyBerry and welcome to a brand new Top 10 Social Media Countdown. Now before we jump into the meat of the matter, I have to say big up to Mannequin Pieces for, you know, this blazing outfit here. Check me out. Oh my God, you never have to look so hot. Jesus, watch ya. Brand new. So if you want to contact them, they're actually located at Shop 2 Central Plaza in Haffertree. And for those of you guys in Montego Bay, you can link them up because they're located at Witter Village, Shop 8 and 9. Mm-hmm. So anyway, all of you guys are going by the carnival. Yes, I are so new and everybody's watching you. But anyway, let us get right into the top 10 countdown that I know you guys are waiting for.
The dirty are the berry, yeah, the juicy are the scoop. All the things are going on, it missing on the news. Tell your sister and your auntie, said the countdown coming soon. All the drama what you want, you fi tune into the youth. Like, yo, hey. Box cover, him cover all the topics like a him name. Pot cover, mix up, blender, all them. Suck me out, what happened now the week, yo, just tune in, scene.
Number 10, Shenseea quits IG.
Strangle me and tie me up.
Me toenail. So the other day, you know, Shenseea burn up Instagram. I do not know, but my girl burn up Instagram for the whole entire Easter weekend. So henty who? I thought that everything was okay, but then I guess, you know, trouble appeared in paradise because Shenseea posted this to her Instagram story detailing her frustration with people knowing her whereabouts. The message is read.
Bro, I have various places where I stay. If you know any one of them, don't effing come to my personal homes asking for pictures, calling out my name, bleaching at my gate for hours, or throwing notes, flowers through my gates. I love my supporters, but I love my personal space as well. And to any one of my neighbors in my apartment or house, stop influencing y'all friends and families like it's okay. And I'm that cool. Yes, I'm cool, but I can be cold too. Don't say nobody come on my rotted yard or call me out of my place asking nothing. This has been going on for far too long. What y'all want to do? Force me to live overseas? You will be disrespected if anybody does that again. Y'all invading my privacy. I've been trying to hold this in, but it's getting far too worse. Every one of my homes is still the same damn thing all the time. I know the love is real, you know. But even when I got security or in a gated community, y'all still bleaching outside. That shit is crazy.
You're not ready at all, ready for all.
Wow, Shenseea, me not really there at your level of stardom or popularity, but me can understand what you're saying because these things actually do happen. Boy, some people online were saying this is what she signed up for, so she have to just work with it. But at the end of the day, whether or not you're a public figure, you know, there are certain little things that you demand, and one of them is just like your own space and privacy, and people just need to understand that. Okay? And after that, no, Shenseea took it up a bit further because my girl completely just went off of Instagram. She took away all of her posts off of her Instagram page, leaving fans stunned. And then she put up this cryptic message. Then she returned to social media with this post that said, I know y'all are concerned. It's just that a lot has been going on in my life right now. Thanks for all the love in my DM, but I'll open up when the time is right.
You're not ready at all, ready for all.
Now, as I said, you know, everybody goes through things. We all have to work out our emotional space. And hopefully Shenseea will take the time that is needed after Carnival, of course, because, you know, she was supposed to be there as part of Exodus and Ramesh Entertainment. But after the whole Soca vibes finish, hopefully you can get some time off to really heal and figure out your situation. Wish you the best, Shenseea. Mm-hmm.
Oh, why? Oh, why?
Number 9, Mama steals the show. Me umbrella. I saw this video the other day on Facebook while I saw, you know, I killed some time. And it featured this mother at a wedding. I guess she was the featured entertainment act while the husband and the wife, you know, sat out the little signing of the papers and all of these things. When I tell you said this mother stole us the show, she shelled down the show. Shell. Pre.
Yeah.
whosoever grandmother is this, she need a raise, she need a bonus, she need every single sort of promotion, because that was a Beyonce Coachella level of entertainment she brought to the people, them wedding. Dance and them little something there, the only thing they left for the lady do is just split and go up on her head top. But yeah man, big up yourself grandma, big up yourself. Book her for weddings, okay? Well now check out the first random video of the week.
Me love you so bad, girl. Me have to tell you no lie. Wi-Fi, baby, you're the one I need in my life. So baby, listen to me. Let me tell you that I really need ya.
Number 8, Jungle Justice, me coconut tree. Okay, so if you don't know, I am big, big fans of Chloe and Halle. They are singers signed by Beyonce and they are actors as well. They're in the show that is called Grown-ish. Anywho, they visited Jamaica recently and they made a post. No, let me just read the post. The post reads,
went to Jamaica for 10 days to refresh our minds, bodies and spirits. We swam in the beautiful waters, basked in God's creations, made some music in the middle of the jungle.
That is what Jamaicans started to just interpret the message, the post, to be. A lot of them, you know, decided, say, you know, in a typical Jamaican style, once them see a post like this, them feel like a style, them a style Jamaica. So people took to them Twitter, took to them Instagram to properly don these young ladies. It's about to go down. One user said, a Portland, them a call jungle.
Grand spent to jungle. Nah, no,
eh. Somebody said, the only forest we know, a black forest cake. Somebody said, born and raised in Jamaica, and I've never been told we have an actual jungle here. So wait there. When you see two coconut tree and some bush, and all of a sudden is a jungle, you think say a Jurassic Park this? Now let me just say, I totally understand how people, when them say the word jungle, it's like it just trigger a certain response. We feel like say people are looked down upon we because we're in the Caribbean and the whole entire negative stereotype that we don't have internet, we don't have no decent car, we live in a hut and all of them little something there. But the truth and in fact is that if you look up the definition of a jungle, this is what it say. An area of land overgrown with dense forests and tangled vegetation, typically in the tropics.
I've been searching through the jungle.
So yeah, I could understand why people came for these two young ladies, Chloe and Halle, because they refer to a part of Jamaica as a jungle. If we are really come talk about it, how we feel because of them and we have one place in a town, one ghetto. One ghetto, if I'm allowed to say the word ghetto, that we refer to as jungle. Oh, nobody never did a black road for that. Hmm?
Huh?
Let me know, burritos, what did you think of this Chloe and Halle jungle conversation? Comment down below. Almost there. Number 7, Trini Coupling. Me mango leaf. I book up this video on Instagram and I don't even know what me need for to say about it. All me have to say is that the woman decided to sugar Renee 630 the man. Just pre. It's a proper lift up the man get. I know the funny thing. It looked like same actually enjoy it, you know. Let me know what you thought about this video, burritos. Comment down below. Number 6, Rhino Hospitalized. Me bite back to, you know, dancehall artist Black Rhino, known for hits such as this.
Come me put up on the bike back. Hold on.
And it's unfortunate that some bad news dominated the social media space talking about his alleged hospitalization. Now, if you know, some months ago or some time ago, rumors that circulate say he died. And then, so when people here say he met in a car accident, everybody was worried.
Nah, man, yeah.
Only fi in at the end, it apparently seems say nothing did go so, because Black Rhino took to Instagram days later to clear the air.
Stop it. From last year, they do it. Last year, they say me have cancer, me in the hospital. Then when I come back in the air again, I see the story pop up again, say me have cancer. See? Then, no, me in accident. But that's why my people them finna say, look at me, me have accident, see? My people them, nobody follow the rumors, man. It never come from my source, it never come from my...
Apparently it was a rumor. It wasn't true. He was never hospitalized, I'm assuming. I would have hoped though that since all of this was just, you know, fake news, I hope he would have, you know, probably took to social media a bit earlier to clear the air instead of waiting until everything got viral and all of that stuff. But let me know what you thought about this entire Black Rhino situation. Comment down below. Number 5, throw a word gone wrong. Me book leaf, known a dancehall industry player, Wani British, died some weeks ago. And it seems as if his funeral also grabbed the spotlight. So apparently the persons who, you know, went to pay their farewell to the funeral at the church were turned away by the pastor because they showed up in skimpy attire. And then after that, to Boxfoot, when they went to the grave, the burial site, little drama happened between the daughter of Wani British and his fiance, because they were trying to figure out whether or not the casket should be opened or just left to be closed. You know, I don't know what to say about emotions, everybody dealing with it, and you can understand how the daughter might have just wanted to take a last look, and probably the fiance just wanted to just have everything rest so that everybody can move on. I do not know, but this is where I make an ask a phone help. Who do you think was in the right? Do you think it's a fiance, or is it a daughter who probably would have had more of a right whether or not the casket should be opened or not? Comments down below. Number 4, Marvin and Mackerel. Me toothpaste. You know, I have to comment Mackerel that week after week, she's stringing this 15 minutes of fame more and more. Every week, she finds some sort of moment that appears to be viral. So, we saw this picture with she and that brother that I guess is now her partner in crime. We saw her with Dexta Daps. We saw her about Dexta Daps, man. Just wait. It's coming up. It's coming up. And then, I guess the person who she is settling with for right now is none other than Marvin the Beast.
You're madder than you go run left me with the most of my head.
Let me tell him, I'm not run left for baby, I stand up and fight with you.
Yeah, yeah. I come from we fight together, stay together.
And then, when they are met, this is the video that they released online.
Yeah.
One thing with Marvin, you know, Marvin knows how to stay current, don't matter what. So if that means say if I go move from Nikisha, that is M and N, to Mackerel, now making it M and M, it's still good for branding, it still works. So congratulations.
M&M.
So let me know, burritos, what do you think of this new dancehall duo, Mackerel and Marvin? Comment down below.
Right about now, it's time for the big up segment.
Well done. Look at the girls, them sexy and young.
Run, club. Sing along. Well done. Big up,
so first up, I have to go and big up gospel artist Omari on the release of his single called Mercy for My People, produced by Chimney Records.
Oh God, I'm crying mercy for my people. I'm hurting cause I cannot see the reason why I'm here.
Also, I have to say big up to the movie Sprinter. You know, after weeks, probably years of promotion, the official promotion came from Will Smith, who is actually the creator of the studio that funded the movie Sprinter. And he posted this video on his Instagram, imploring as many of you guys to get Sprinter in a theater near you.
What's up, y'all? My company, Overbrook Entertainment, is releasing a film called Sprinter. Sprinter is a beautiful film about a young Jamaican track star set to be Jamaica's next track and field sensation. And we really follow all of his trials and tribulations as he works hard to preserve his talent and not have his light be stamped out. We can all relate to that a little bit. What's interesting in what we're doing and what I need y'all for, what I need y'all for, is we're experimenting with the release of this film. And what we're doing is called theatrical on demand. So the movie's available in theaters, and we've partnered with a company called FilmRise. So you can get it in theaters, but you gotta demand it.
Demand it.
So I need y'all to go to sprinterthefilm.com and find out how you can help this beautiful film get to the world.
Are you sure you want to do this?
I'm going to America to help our family.
Mama! Set!
Number 3, A Long Walk to Riri.
Rihanna for endorsing Buju Banton and Coffee as well this week. The singer attended Buju Banton's Long Walk to Freedom concert in Barbados. And she was seen jamming to some Coffee. Number 2, Escobar cries. My fridge stop. So, you know, on the countdown, I have the good with the bad, the emotional, the sad with the happy and the glad. Everything has to be a good combination. And boy, this video, it definitely is going to be on a more somber tone. This is one of these rare moments where you really see a Jamaican man in the dancehall space, such as Bishop Escobar, and his sign to Ramesh. He's a selector, popular selector, well known and all of these things, actually having a moment where he's comfortable enough to share what happened to him and how it made him emotional. Pre the video.
IG, big bad thing. But the only other one that won really a go on in my life, you know, dog. But I have to thank God, I swear to God, but I have to thank God, I'm not going to stop. I hit the traffic, I'm going to stop. Because somebody something. But I'm look at my youth. But me and the man used to go to school. The man mad. Like real mad, me I tell you. The man not even remember me, the man not even know me. I'm stopping in the man some food, I'm look. I would have afraid of you to go to school with, dog. You know the thing, like up a chip me. I swear to God, people, I'm a gig on dog, so I would have stopped wearing my one in the arm.
No, honestly, when I first saw this video, I thought it's one of them die-die type of, you know, Lala Milan type of, you know, that fake ball type of thing that ends up being a joke in the end. But it's a good thing I watched it because the message was definitely impactful. And now check out the second random video of the week. And number one goes to... Dexta Daps, dapping on stage! Woo! Woo! My word, my sentence, my paragraph, my essay, my bibliotheca! So, Dexta Daps has been laying low recently, you know, so even they have been big bad year when he launched a song and video for Bring It To The Owner, and since then he's been just kind of keeping chill, kind of make other artists do them thing. But it seemed like him say, yo, enough of that waiting, guess who is back? I am ready to take over things, and you know the only way you can do that is to just kind of excite social media a bit. You have to do something interesting, something new on the social media space, so people can start talking about you once more. And that is exactly what Dexta Daps did, because he's been taking over social media in a very Adult Swim, late night HBO and cinema, Google Chrome incognito type of way. Oh yeah, yes, me can't go further, but I want to know more. Dexta has been posting these very exotic sort of risque performances with female patrons, and boy, the internet has been talking. Right about now, no brother do not want to send them girl to no Dexta Daps show, because, but then again, if you have a girl and that girl go up to Dexta Daps and go volunteer for yourself, and get all of that titty pop out and them little something there, things that swell up and squeeze up and all, and I'm not your girl anymore, I'm Dexta Daps own. Dexta Daps owner right there and dead. I want to know from you, Berridos, what do you think about it? Some people say he must get banned from stage for doing acts like this. Others say like, yo, load the man doing thing. Some people just say, hear what? Do you think next time I'm just not going to send my girl to your show? Because, yeah, I don't want you to come too far. What I want to know, what are your thoughts, burritos? Leave a comment down below. Well, that is it, people. Thank you so much for watching another Dutty Berry Top 10 social media countdown. I promised you that I would be back really, really quickly and see me a whole show to my words. So you can leave me a little clap now and big me up while you're watching this live right about now. You YouTube family, make sure you leave a comment. Because I'm tired of bada uno. Also, there's something called a super chat. So if you want to, you know, support the thing and leave a little chukum pengs, you know, dear little thing, you know, I'm not body up and all of these things. As well as I'm doing a lot of hostings these days. So if you want to book me for any events, feel free to just contact me. The information will be down below. Follow me on my social media pages at DuttyBerryShow on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all over. Especially me, follow me on my Twitter, see there, right? So DuttyBerryShow, follow me. I want more of you to be on the Twitter hard page. Also, to ensure that you tune into my weekly Game of Thrones review, because you know them don't hard normal, so you know you have to go and check them out and support the spoiler alert competition, where you can win a chance to collect some awesome GOT merchandise and party packages courtesy of Supreme Ventures Limited /SV Games. And all you have to do is just to leave your prediction saying what you think will happen in the next Game of Thrones episode. That is it, people. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks so much for the love. A lot of you guys reached out to me as it relates to, like, you know, my little anxiety talk and them something there. Thank you so much. It's well appreciated. Take care until next week.
30 are the berry, yeah, the juicy, yeah, the scoop. All the things are going on, they're missing on the news. Tell your sister and your auntie, said the corner coming soon. All the drama when you want, you for tuning to the youth. Like, yo,